to the show. It's time, let's go. Grab your friends and get ready. Here comes our friend Neddy. Let's open up our Bibles. Become true disciples. Y'all ready to grow? It's the Neddy Show. Let's go.
Hey everyone, and welcome to the Treehouse. I'm Mr. Blake, and today's gonna be an amazing day. Isn't that right, Neddy?
Oh, you know it, Mr. Blake! Because not only did I eat 17 Pop-Tarts, 14 pieces of Cheeto bacon, and one glass of ostrich milk for breakfast, but today we also get to learn about God!
You've got that right. And today we are going to be learning about how to talk with God. And to do that, it's really simple.
Whoa. That's okay, Mr. Blake. I'm way ahead of you. I know exactly what you're thinking.
You do?
Well, yeah, Mr. Blake. And I know exactly what you were about to say about how to talk to God.
Neddy, I really don't think you do.
Mr. Blake, say no more. I'm already on my way there to talk to God.
On your way where? Neddy, I really don't think we're on the same page here.
See you later, Mr. Blake. I'll meet you there and get everything ready to go to talk to God. Bye.
Neddy, wait, come back. Wait, Neddy, come back. Well, what I was gonna say is that we can talk directly to God through something known as prayer. Today, our main point is I talk to God through prayer. And come on, say it with me. I talk to God through prayer. Great job. All right, well, I better go find Neddy. He could be anywhere at this point. See ya.
All right, thanks for your help, Randy.
Hey everybody, I've been looking all around town for Neddy, but I can't seem to find him anywhere. I've checked all of his favorite places to go, like Bob Orlando's Market, Pirate Achu's Ship, even Godfather's Pizza, and even his friend Miles can't find him. I hope he's okay. It's times like these when talking to God really comes in handy. Prayer is one of our ways to communicate with God, and just like you would talk to a parent or friend on the phone, God says in the Bible in Jeremiah 33:3, "Call to me and I will answer." Prayer is simply having a conversation with God. It's our chance to praise Him and thank Him for all the amazing things that He's done for us in our lives. It's also our chance to tell Him our thoughts, desires, dreams, concerns, and requests. The Bible even says that through the Holy Spirit, God can even understand our groans and cries. With God, prayer is super simple. We can use it when we are lost, when we need a friend, or simply when we just aren't sure what to do next. Like in the story of a woman named Hannah from the Bible. The Bible said that after many years, she was unable to have any children. So, Hannah pleaded with God for a son, promising to give him back to the Lord. Sure enough, God gave Hannah a son named Samuel. He became the greatest prophet in Israel's history, who maintained direct communication with God throughout his entire life. In addition to Samuel, God gave Hannah three more sons and two daughters. God heard Hannah's prayers, and He hears yours too. I talk to God through prayer. Prayer is absolutely amazing. His word says that if we ask for anything according to His will, He hears us, which actually is our memory verse and what it's all about. But before we check it out, let's pray for God's help in finding Neddy. Lord, thank you so much for loving us and this amazing day. Lord, give us the wisdom to find where Neddy is. Thank you. And we love you. And all God's people said, amen. Hey, what's that sound? It sounds like music. You know what? I think I know where to go next. And while I go, let's check out our memory verse. All right.
Hey everyone, it's me, Miss Maddie, and it's time for our memory verse. Remember, we do our memory verse so that you can keep it in your heart all the time. Our verse today comes from the book of 1 John, and it shows us just how much God loves when we pray. We can go to Him with all of our needs because He hears our prayers. So, when you're ready, say, let's go!
Let's go!
Great! We're gonna say the verse three times. First, I'll say it, then you're gonna repeat after me, and then we'll say it all together. All right, let's do it. This is the confidence we have in approaching God. that if we ask anything according to His will, He hears us. 1 John 5:14. Great job, everyone. Now repeat after me. This is the confidence we have in approaching God, that if we ask anything according to His will, He hears us. 1 John 5:14. Wow, that was amazing. Now let's say it all together. This is the confidence we have in approaching God, that if we ask anything according to His will, He hears us. 1 John 5:14. Great job, everyone. That was amazing, and I love that verse. Now remember, keep saying it and keep it in your heart.
When night has fallen, when fear is coming, still you're calling me. When faith is lost and my hope exhausted, you will be my strength. When my mind says I'm not good enough, God, you're enough for me. Yeah, I've decided I'm not giving up, 'cause you won't give up on me. Promises to me.
You love is all the
It's Haley Beth. How's it going?
Hi, Mr. Blake. It's so good to see you. I'm just here in my music shop, you know, organizing all of my records reverse alphabetically and by smell.
Yeah. Cool.
Also, I had a feeling you might be coming by soon.
Wait, you did?
Earlier today, I saw Neddy come by the store and I was like, hey, what are you doing? And he was like, oh, I'm going to the observatory on the outskirts of town. And I was like, what is that?
Well, first off, that was a really great Neddy.
Thank you. I've been practicing.
You can tell, but the observatory, that's on the outskirts of town. I wonder what he's going there for. There's not much out there except for some old radios and telescopes and that old satellite. Wait, I think I might know what Neddy's up to.
What do you mean?
Well, if I know Neddy, he loves technology and inventions. And today, our main point is I talk to God through prayer.
Oh, I love that. Prayer is such a big part of my life.
Yeah, me too. But when I said that we were going to be learning how to talk to God, he must have thought that he could use the satellite at the old observatory to talk to him.
Well, that's silly. You don't need any special tool to talk to God. We can do it anywhere and anytime. It even says in Psalms 145 verse 18 that the Lord is near to all who call on him.
Wow, that's really good, Miss Haley Beth. I talk to God through prayer.
Oh, that reminds me of an old record that I had somewhere. Where? Oh, there it is. It's a song all the way back from the 1950s, and it's all about prayer. It's by Buddy Prescott, and it's called Pray Every Day. The words of the song are amazing, and they teach us all about prayer. Let's check it out.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us of our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
I talk to God through prayer. God gives me courage to pray. Jesus empowers my prayers. I pray every day. I get a response with thanksgiving and praise. I look to the Lord and His strength and always seek His face. It's okay, it's alright. Pray every day
and every night.
Praying something now, I'm praying something now. I'm praying something now, I'm praying something now. I'm praying something now, I'm praying something now.
Wow, that was so awesome. And Buddy Prescott, I mean, that's one cool dude. Am I the only one that thinks that, hey, I don't know, he kind of looks like someone we both know, I don't know, maybe me?
I don't think so.
Really?
There's really like no resemblance.
Huh, I thought we could be twins.
Nope, definitely not.
Okay, well, thanks so much for your help, Miss Haley Beth. I better go catch up with Neddy at the old observatory. I'll see you later.
Anytime. And remember, every Saturday is half off records that are cut in half. See you later.
All right, see ya.
1972.
And now it's time for the joke of the day.
Yarg, I be Pirate Achoo here with the joke of the day. Why can't pirates learn the alphabet? Because they keep getting lost at sea. Wait a minute. I don't get it. That's very strange. Wait a minute. Where are we? Oh, no. We're lost at sea. Oh, I get it now. Lost at sea. But seriously, this is a problem. Yoy, me mateys. Someone find a map.
And that was the joke of the day.
Oh, yeah, that should just about do it. We're going to be talking to God in no time.
Neddy, I finally found you.
Oh, hey, Mr. Blake, it's about time you made it here. Well, I was starting to think that we were on the same page at all. I hooked up this old computer to this old radio satellite so that we can pick up sound waves from over 500,000 miles away. And I rigged its operate at the same distance directly into the sky. And maybe, just maybe, we'll be talking with God.
Well, Neddy, while I really do appreciate the effort, this is not at all what I was talking about when I was talking about talking to God.
It's not? But then what was it?
Prayer, Neddy. In fact, today our main point is I talk to God through prayer.
Oh, prayer? Well, I'm not sure I'm familiar with that piece of equipment. Did you find it online or something? Amazon's been real spotty lately, and Prime just isn't what it used to be.
No, Neddy. Prayer is our way of directly talking to God anytime, anywhere, and about anything.
Wow! Well, that sounds awesome! And a lot less expensive and, complicated.
It sure is. Anyone can do it, and God encourages all of us to pray every single day, all the time, and about anything. It says in 1 Thessalonians to pray without stopping. God is always listening to our prayers, and just like our memory verse says, if we ask anything according to His will, He hears us.
Oh man, Mr. Blake, that sounds awesome. Well, I better go shut down this old satellite before it overheats.
Yeah, I'll come help you.
Everyone, welcome to my mailroom/bakery shop. Making tasty treats and delivering mail is something that makes me so happy. But so does something else. The core values. Our first core value is love God, because God loved us first. Our God is so big, and so is His love for us. So I found the biggest treat I could. Let's see if it's done. Oh, there it is, a cake. So, on the count of three, we're gonna say love God with our biggest and loudest voices. Are you ready? One, two, three. Love God! Wow, that was so great! Our second core value is, well, hold on, I left it somewhere around here, let me see. Oh, there it is! Love people, because God loves all people. Mail allows us to reach and love people all around the world. So when you're ready, we're gonna make a big round world with our hands, like this. Love people. One, two, three. Love people. Wow, splendid. Our third core value is do your best, because God will do the rest. And to show you this core value, I thought of the best treat that I could. Donuts. Oh, delicious. Let's all pretend to take a big bite out of our donut on three like this. Oh, delicious. One, two, three. Do your best. Delicious. Our fourth and final core value is quite incredible. It's have fun, because God gives us joy. And because of this, I believe that's quite a cause for celebration. So, on the count of three, let's say have fun with a little cheerio at the end like this. Have fun. Cheerio. One, two, three. Have fun. Cheerio. Great job. And speaking of fun, cheerio indeed. Well, thanks for stopping by my shop for the core values. These are delicious.
Could be forgiven.
That we learned that we don't need all of this machinery to talk to God. You know, anytime you're feeling lost or you aren't sure what to do next, prayer is our first resort. God wants to talk to you, and He wants to be your very best friend. But maybe you're feeling far from God today, or maybe you don't know Him at all. If that's you, I want to tell you that God loves you so much, and He wants to come into your heart and be your very best friend forever. And the coolest part is that all we have to do is ask. So right now, I want you to close your eyes, bow your head, and say this prayer with me. Dear Jesus, thank you for giving your life on the cross for me. Lord, forgive me for all my mistakes. Make me brand new and be my very best friend. Lord, help me to pray. I love you and I thank you. And it's in your name we pray. And all God's people said, amen. Wow, if that was your very first time asking God into your heart, I want you to know that I am so proud of you. And I want you to tell somebody in your life that you love and trust, because they're gonna be so proud of you too.
Mr. Blake! Oh, what's up, Mr. Blake? Man, I talk to God through prayer. That's so good, Mr. Blake, but it sure is a shame that We came all this way out here for nothing. I mean, a satellite that can connect sound waves from so many miles away sure is cool.
Yeah, it really is a shame, but this is a good lesson, Neddy, because sometimes...
Hello!
What was that?
I'm not really sure.
Hello!
God! Is that you? I knew it would work!
What? No! No, this is actually Todd from New Westville! The next town over from New Eastville! Who am I speaking with?
Sorry, Todd! This is, Neddy! And we were actually trying to use this satellite to, talk to God!
Well, that's silly! Everyone knows that you can't talk to God through prayer! Not a satellite!
Thank you, Todd! Thank you so much! Oh, boy! That was great! I really appreciate Todd, you know, letting us know that we can't talk to God through, you know, a computer and a big satellite. Thanks, Todd! But everybody remember, I talk to God through prayer.
Yeah, that's so good, Neddy. Actually, I forgot to mention, Neddy, Randy actually invited us to his brand new pizza flavor tasting at Godfather's Pizza.
Oh, that sounds so good! Let's go there right now!
Yeah. I talk
to God. Whoa! Are you singing Pray Every Day by Buddy Prescott?
Yeah, you know Buddy Prescott too?
Oh, I love that song. Buddy Prescott is awesome.
Yeah, doesn't he look a little bit maybe exactly like me?
What? Not at all, Mr. Blake. You're funny.
What? Well, Neddy, he does look like me. Exactly like me. See you later, everyone. Neddy, it's all in the eyes.